Cypher Knights. And this is the thank you. I'm gonna try that again, because that was exciting. I am Sir Boris of the Noble Cypher Knights!
Yeah!
Pardon my tardiness, I just got back from the Haven. There are fairies there. Did you know that? Well, of course you knew that. I'm gonna stand over here. You are here for the Goblin Dating Game, the most popular Goblin Dating Game anywhere, because we invented it. And you'll see why also in a minute. This game here is designed for you that come to the ball to find magic, to find wonder, and to find love in all the wrong places.
All right.
Thank you. You can cheer. That was about you. So you can applaud yourselves. So in a moment, we will be bringing up three very lovely, delightful, housebroken, fairly goblins for a young contestant to choose from to find romance. Now, this is my favorite part. We're going to choose that contestant. If you are here looking for love, or maybe just a new love, you know, I don't know what time of night it is, but it might be that time to change it up. Raise your hands. Who here is looking for love, or who here is with a friend that's looking for love? You, yes? Anyone? No one? Are you all scared? Right here?
Yes.
Here is a fancy, yes. I like your hat. Would you like to join us for a chance at finding some love? Right this way. Right this way. Clapping. This is also free, which is what you don't get to keep. But you do get to keep the memories you're about to make. Because not only are you looking for love, but once you have found it, and trust me, you will win a fabulous date for two right here this very night. Are you excited?
I'm very excited.
Are you still happy you raised your hand?
No, but that's okay.
Excellent! Excellent! All right. Before I bring them up, Papa Midnight, do you have any words of wisdom or warning for our contestants?
Well, to let all of you people out there know, our goblins do not care about human gender. They love all of you equally.
That's very nice. Oh, love is a strong word. It is a four-letter word around these parts as well, but that's delightful. All right, Papa Midnight, please introduce us to our goblins.
Okay, we are going to introduce Goblin Number One. Let's hear for Goblin Number One. Next up, Goblin Number Two. And Goblin Number These are our three sexy goblins.
Ooh. If you're into that kind of thing, but we love all types here. All right, before we begin, is there anything that our goblin contestants should know about you?
He's wearing a top hat.
He is wearing a top hat. Fancy. Tell everyone.
I like dancing.
You like dancing?
Definitely.
All right.
Looking for a goblin that dances.
Looking for a goblin that dances, and maybe we'll have a chance to ask them about that. All right. Now, those of you who are not familiar, the way this works is that our contestant asks our goblins each a question, then we do a lightning round, and then they make their choice. All final choices are permanent. I don't make the rules, I just announce them in full of rooms of beautiful people. All right. Are you ready to find the goblin?
Yes, I'm ready.
All right. Do you have your first question?
I do.
All right, let's hear it. Goblin Number One, your question is?
Goblin Number One, hello. What do you like to do on a first date?
Oh, I like to take two tango classes because there's one man who taught me tango Spanish. It was sexy. I want a sexy with you.
Just a reminder. reminder, this is a mature room. Plug your ears. All right, well, there's that. Oh, he does. Yes, he does have a mustache. All right, so there's that from Goblin number one. Do you have a question for Goblin number two?
Goblin number two. If you get me, what do you want to do with me?
Well, ideally, I would like to make you happy. So if I win, then I would like to take you home to cook you dinner. I would teach you how to cook my favorite mud pie recipe and make it with swamp juice. It's really good. I cook.
Was surprisingly endearing. This might not be that bad. All right. Goblin number three.
She eats people though.
I mean, sometimes.
I have a feeling I'm going to be the dinner. I'm a little worried.
I'm sorry. Let me get Goblin number three.
Goblin number three. Do you like dancing?
Dancing. Yeah. I like dancing, and I like building things too. Yeah.
Was that your answer?
Yeah.
Can I phone a friend?
You know, maybe, yeah. Should we ask the audience for a question?
I think so.
Audience, do you have a question that our eligible young bachelors should ask the goblins? Just go ahead and shout them out. Any other suggestions? I'm pretty sure we know the answer to that. Anyone else?
That was Goblin number one.
That was a good one. Well then, let's not ask the audience anymore. Not as bad as they are. Is Goblin number one? Do you have a question for Goblin number two?
Goblin number two. Do you like dancing?
Do I like dancing?
Give us a little sampling. It was very sensual. Do you have a question for Goblin number three?
Yes.
Goblin number three. If we go on a date, what are you going to wear for me?
Boy, Goblin number three, what are you going to wear on your dates?
Well, nothing but my nice green bunny.
We need bigger, mature audience signs on the fronts. So dancing is very important to you, right? Someone that you're going to be with, you want to make sure that they can move and groove with you as well, yes? Do you have any particular, what is your favorite type of music to dance to?
I don't know, if you go down to the throne room, I guess whatever they're playing, sounds good.
So some sort of more elegant,
exactly.
Courtly waltz.
Definitely.
Well, you know, in the case, I have a question then. This is for all the goblins here.
Okay.
And let's just say this will be the last question, because I think I'm pushing my luck. All right. After this, if you were to be down in the throne room with all the fancy dancers, and you were to catch our contestant's eye across the dance floor, what move would you bust in order to catch their attention and entrap their hearts? This is a visual. Show the audience, what would you do to catch their eye?
I'll together a one.
No, one at a time.
Goblin one.
No peeking. Trust me. There was that.
Goblin two.
Okay, Goblin two.
Classic. Love it.
And Goblin three.
I wasn't ready for that. All right. Do you have enough information to make a choice?
I do.
All right.
I definitely
now,
do.
Now, while you deliberate, audience, cheer for your favorite goblin. We have goblin number one.
Well, goblin number one was very sexy, and goblin number three really was amazing in ways I can't really describe. But I think goblin two has stolen my heart.
Before you meet goblin number two, I want you to gaze upon those that you have passed on. Let's have you meet goblin number one.
With an eyeball.
Please, here's looking at you. All right, goblin number three, come on down. Can you show me that little dance move you did? And away he goes. Don't worry, it happens to him. And may I present to you your date for the remainder of the evening, goblin number two!
Dream that I could speak.
dream that I can't.